We're launching Detect, and we're really excited about this because this is a way to track from a smartwatch a person's heart rate and to know well before people have fever and symptoms whether there's a cluster of abnormalities that's happening. We can't say whether it's the coronavirus or whether it's influenza, but at least we can see something, predict something very accurately so that we can put an alert. And it's real time, it's continuous, it's scalable. And so we're really very keen on this added ability to be able to detect an emerging problem potentially in any part of the geography of the United States. Well, the problem we have right now is to do tests, whether it's from a body fluid, blood, or any means of actual contact. There's the inconvenience of having to go to a lab or sending a specimen. There's also showing up to a place where other people may get your infection or you get theirs. So what if you could do that from a wristband, just getting things like heart rate? And so we can do that now. We've shown that we could do that as well as the CDC. And so it's an added feature. It's a whole another way to look at a person's well-being. If they have a resting heart rate, which is abnormal, that could be an early sign, even before there's a fever or any other symptoms, that something's not right, especially when you see a cluster in a community. We have really what's called nowcasting. It's almost like if you were looking at a Google map for traffic, and that's what this is, a real-time assessment, which is superior because in the setting of infectious disease, you could test negative one day and then change the next day. This is real-time continuous assessment. We've been pioneering digital health for about 13 years. I think we were the first program academic in the country. And we learned right straight away is that this sensor world, where you understand the physiology of each person, is an extraordinary way to get a handle, continuous, unobtrusive, and you can of course tailor it as you need to for what you're interested in. In the setting of this COVID-19, it gives us a handle on things like heart rate, which we know is a great antecedent abnormality before people get sick. So by tracking people at scale, we'll be able to see an outbreak as we saw with flu in a way that previously has not been obtainable.